Hey there, I hope you're ready for some fun, because we're practicing division in this video. Aw, these cats have their own compartments for food, so their food can be divided evenly, so each cat gets enough.
Because you know, Mr. Whiskers, cats deserve their fair share.
If you're new, sometimes I talk to Mr. Whiskers, okay? Anyway, division. Division is when we split a number up by a certain number. Let's say there are four apples. Michael and Liam want to split the apples, and they want to make sure it's fair. There are four apples, and we are dividing the apples into two groups, one for Michael and one for Liam. Four divided by two. This symbol right here is the division sign. It shows us we're dividing. What is four divided by two? Yeah, two. That's right. Four divided by two equals two. If Michael and Liam are splitting these four apples, they each get two. Check out this one. Let's say there are six bottles of water and there are six kids playing outside. That would be six divided by six. If we split the six bottles by six, how many water bottles does each kid get? One. Great job. Six divided by six equals one. Everyone gets one water bottle. All right, next, let's practice division with school supplies. Let's say there are nine brand new pencils that three students are going to split. Nine divided by three. We're dividing the nine pencils between the three students so that the students each get the same number of pencils. When we divide nine by three, how many pencils does each student get? Yes, three. Great job. That means nine divided by three equals three. If you split nine into equal groups of three, there are three in each group. Nine divided by three equals three. Awesome job. Before we practice more division, I want to ask you a quick question. What is the answer to a division problem called? What is the answer to a division problem called? The quotient. Yeah, the quotient. That's a cool word. Let's say that together. The quotient. Right. Can we say it one more time just a little louder? The quotient. Yeah, the quotient. Okay, so we practiced 4 divided by 2, which equals 2. 2 is the quotient. We did 6 divided by 6, which equals 1. 1 is the quotient for that problem. And we just did 9 divided by 3, which equals 3. That means 3 is the quotient for that problem. The quotient is the answer to a division problem. And don't worry, Crab. We're going, okay? We have more division to do. Oh my goodness, it's somebody's birthday! Speaking of birthdays, here's a man celebrating his birthday with just one candle. I'm not sure what he's saying, but I like to think he's saying, "I put one candle on my cake." And she responds, "That's great. That's great." We're going to be dealing with more than one candle, though. In fact, imagine we have seven candles. Seven of them. Now, in the other division examples, we divided a number into multiple groups. But in this example, we are only going to divide seven by one, because all of the candles are going on the same cake. Seven divided by one. And the answer is super simple. How many candles does each group have? Well, there's just one group, and all seven candles are on it. So the answer is seven. Yes, seven divided by one equals seven. Seven is the quotient. Anytime you divide a number by one, the quotient is that number, because all of it is going into just one group. For example, 9 divided by 1 equals 9. It's 9 just getting put into one group. 40 divided by 1 equals 40. It's 40 getting divided into just one group. 1,000 divided by 1 equals 1,000. It's 1,000 divided into just one group. When you divide a number by one, it's super simple. The quotient is that number.
Whoa, look at these two bears.
These two bears are going to share some fish, okay? They're going to evenly divide some fish, okay? Whoa, bears, you both are friends. You both need to share these fish, okay? Evenly, we're gonna divide them up. So there are a total of 10 fish, and we are dividing the 10 fish into two groups, one for each bear. 10 divided by 2. The quotient, the answer to the division problem, will tell us how many fish each bear gets. What is 10 divided by 2? Yeah, 5. Great! 10 divided by 2 equals 5. And you can see, each bear gets 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fish. 10 divided by 2 equals 5. Awesome job! Aw, hello doggies! Are any of you hungry? I'm asking because, well, I have good news for the four of you. We have dog biscuits for you to share. We just want to divide them evenly so each of you gets the same amount. We have 12 dog biscuits here. 12 of them. And there are four dogs. 12 divided by 4. We have to divide or split up the 12 dog biscuits into four equal groups. 12 divided by 4 will tell us how many dog biscuits each dog will receive. What is 12 divided by 4? 3! Great job! 12 divided by 4 equals 3. Each dog will get 3 dog biscuits. 12 divided by 4 equals 3. 3 is the quotient. You are doing an incredible job. Let's try this one next. How many people do you see here? 5. There are 5 people who have been playing outside and are going to take a quick snack break. Thankfully, they brought strawberries. They have 20 strawberries in all and want to divide them amongst each other. This will be fun. So there are 20 strawberries in all, and we are dividing them into 5 groups, one for each person. 20 divided by 5. What is 20 divided by 5? Yeah, 4. Awesome! 20 divided by 5 equals 4. That means each person gets 4 strawberries. 20 divided by 5 equals 4. 4 is the quotient. Great! Hey, I think it's time for a division fact. It's division fact time! When you have a division problem, the total number is called the dividend. The number of groups you are splitting it up into is called the divisor. And the answer, as we've already talked about, is called the quotient. Now, a cool thing about division is you can switch the divisor and the quotient, and the division problem remains true. For example, 8 divided by 4 equals 2, but also 8 divided by 2 equals 4. Interesting. The divisor and the quotient can be switched, and the division problem remains true. I'll show you with bananas. Bananas are so tasty! We have 8 bananas here. 8 divided by 4 equals 2. Dividing the 8 bananas into 4 groups means each group has, 2 bananas in it. Cool. Now, if we flip the 4, which is the divisor, and the 2, which is the quotient, it remains true. So 8 divided by 2 equals 4. If we divide the 8 bananas into 2 groups, we see there are 4 bananas in each group. That's pretty awesome. And speaking of awesome, the next example is from the world of tennis. Have you ever played tennis before? Okay. I enjoy tennis. It's a fun sport. Let's say there are a total of 16 tennis balls, and 2 tennis players want to split them up. 16 divided by 2. 16 divided by 2 will tell us how many tennis balls each player will get. What is 16 divided by 2? 8. There are 8 tennis balls in each of these two groups. 16 divided by 2 equals 8. Okay, so 16 divided by 2 equals 8. Now remember, the total we are dividing is called the dividend. The dividend is 16. The number of groups you are splitting it into is called the divisor. The divisor in this division problem is 2. And what is the answer to a division problem called? Yeah, the quotient. Great job. The quotient in this problem is the number 8. Now, we learned that we can switch the divisor and the quotient, and it remains true. Let's put that to the test with this. We'll try 16 divided by 8, which will be 2. Here are the 16 tennis balls again, but this time we'll divide them into 8 groups because the divisor is 8. In this case, 8 players are splitting the 16 tennis balls. How many are in each group? 2. 16 divided by 8 equals 2. Fantastic job. So you really can switch the divisor and the quotient, and the answer remains true. That's really cool. Okay, let's look at a few final division problems. If you don't know the answer, that's all right. Division can take practice, and you'll learn a cool new division fact for next time. Here's the first one. 9 divided by 9. What is 9 divided by 9? Yes, 1! 9 divided by 9 equals 1. If you have 9 and divide them into 9 groups, there is 1 in each group. 9 divided by 9 equals 1. 1 is the quotient. Great job! Here's the next one. 14 divided by 2. What is 14 divided by 2? 7. 14 divided by 2 equals 7. If you have 14 and divide it into 2 groups, each group has 7 in it. 14 divided by 2 equals 7. 7 is the quotient. Fantastic. All right, here's the last one. What is 15 divided by 3? What is 15 divided by 3? Awesome! 5! Yeah! 15 divided by 3 equals 5. If you have 15 and divide it into 3 groups, each group has 5 in it. 15 divided by 3 equals 5. 5 is the quotient. You did such an amazing job. Even if you didn't know all of these, you are well on your way to being a division master. Aw, the cats from earlier. The food was divided up, and each cat has enough. The magic of division. Anything to add, Mr. Whiskers? That's okay, Mr. Whiskers. Division means a lot to me, too. Hey, thanks for hanging out with me and practicing division. That was super cool. If you had a great time and want to watch more fun videos, you can click the subscribe button if you haven't yet. I want to give a big thank you to all of my patrons for making videos like this one possible. And thank you for watching and for being so awesome. I'll see you on the next video.